Hello everyone, welcome to HNG Reading. Today we are going to discuss about a very important topic which most of my clients are asking me, that is it necessary to use expensive steel or cement for construction purpose to get good quality? Well, to get this answer, please watch this video till end. Before we start our video, I would like to request you to please like this video, share this video and subscribe to my channel to get construction related videos. Without getting any further delay, let's get started. As I said earlier, most of my clients are asking me that, is it necessary to use expensive material for construction in order to get good quality? Well, I used to tell them that obviously it is good to use expensive steel and cement for construction, but more than that, having proper workmanship and proper execution of the work under supervision is most important. In this video, I will tell you some tips to follow for good quality construction. First, we can discuss about RCC, that is reinforced cement concrete structure. As you will be aware that RCC structure is main skeleton of the building, and we must make sure that RCC structure of your building are being constructed with good quality and strength. Tip 1 is about mixing proportion. For your information, concrete strength is mainly depend upon two points, that is the lesser voids and the lesser water in cement concrete structure increases more strength. I repeat that the lesser voids and the lesser water in concrete increases more strength. So to reduce the voids in concrete, we must have proper mixing ratio. Either it is standard mix ratio or design mix ratio, and we have to use vibrator for proper compaction. That is, in concrete, proper mixing ratio, whether it is M20 or M25 or whatever the ratio will be, design mix is more important than using expensive cement. I am not telling you that using expensive cement and steel is not so important. I am telling that proper workmanship is also more important to attain good strength in concrete structures. The next point is water cement ratio in concrete. As I said earlier, the lesser voids and the lesser water in concrete increases more strength. Most of the time, laborers are mixing plenty of water in concrete to get good workability, which reduces the strength of concrete. To avoid this issue, we can use a special mix design for concrete, which we can get from structural engineer, or we can use admixture chemicals during mixing of concrete, which will increases workability in concrete, or we can use RMC, that is ready mix concrete. Next point is about water tightness in centering. That is, we should conceal all the centering gap holes to avoid escaping of cement slurry. If the cement slurry in concrete getting reduced, then obviously strength of the concrete also will be reduced. Next point is about water quality. This is very very important point to be considered before starting of your construction. No matter which quality of steel and cement you are using, if you use hard water, then there will be high chances of a steel getting rust in future. Then quality of materials. Quality of sand and jelly should be good, nearly equal in sizes, and should be clean and free from all the dust. Then structural members like footing, columns, beams and slab should be as per structural drawing to avoid further problems in future. The next point is there should be no honeycomb in concrete. As I said earlier, there should be less voids in concrete. The less voids in concrete increases more strength in concrete. Honeycomb in concrete reduces strength, so we should avoid it. Then next point is about cover block. To avoid the corrosion in steel in future, we must provide proper compaction, proper cover block. As you can see in photo, this is the result of not keeping proper cover block during concrete. Next, we can discuss about brick wall construction. points to be considered is we should use soaked brick during construction with the proper mix, that is cement mortar 1:4 for 4.5 walls and 1:6 for 9 inches wall, or it should be as suggested by your structural engineer with respect to the type of that building. And brick should be properly leveled horizontally as well as vertically. That should also be checked. And the next point is about curing. We must do proper curing for at least 7 days. Next point is about button marking. Button marking to be done before plastering to get proper levels and proper thickness of the plastering. And the next point is about plastering ratio, that is a cement mortar mix 1:3 for ceiling plastering and 1:5 for 1:5 to 1:6 for interior plastering. That's all for today's video. The rest of the tips will be shared in the next video, inshallah. And if you want any topic to be discussed related construction, please mention it in comment box below. Please like this video, share this video with your friends and family members. Thank you. Khuda Hafiz.